I believe defending a championship is way harder than becoming a champion. There's always more pressure defending, keeping that title that you work hard to get. Anyone, whoever wants to become champion, they just want to destroy you. They want to take what's yours. And with a guy like Jake Biel, he just wants to destroy you. But he would always nag and put you down. He would step on you and step on you.
Amigo!
Crush you down and just make you feel this big. Being the smallest superstar in that ring, facing giants in a world of giants, that was my fuel to overcome every time I stepped into the ring with him. I had finally reached the pinnacle of WWE by winning the World Heavyweight Championship at WrestleMania in honor of my good friend, Eddie Guerrero. As a World Heavyweight Champion, I knew I had a target on my back and would face some of my toughest opponents, including John Bradshaw Layfield. JBL always made it very easy to get motivated for a match. His loudmouth, the constant mockery, and his knack for crossing the line to make things personal. He didn't think I was a real champion. Champion went into Judgment Day ready to show him that all his bluster and power wasn't enough to stop Rey Mysterio.
Thank you.
face. See this happen because I was on the floor, and I'm glad I didn't, because I would have got right back up and kicked him in the face.
Thank you.
I remember hitting JBL with the baseball slide dropkick right at the side of meant a ton to me. And of course... the big red machine, Kane, had his sight set on eliminating me from WWE in 2008. The monstrous 7-foot-tall behemoth took pleasure in mocking my pain and misery. Kane thought he could use his mind games to break me, but I wasn't gonna let that happen. It's tough keeping your head in the game when facing someone so sick and sadistic, but at Cyber Sunday, where the WWE Universe would choose our match stipulation, the fans chose no holds barred. I didn't know what type of strategy I was gonna bring to the table that night. My technique has always been aerial maneuvers. Was I gonna be able to get away with it at an no-holds-barred match? I made a promise to myself that I wasn't going to show fear. How do I take the big man down? Hit him with whatever I got. I was gonna meet him head-on, regardless of the match type, and show him that you can't break Rey Mysterio.
Thank you. hits you, takes you out.
Come on.
I took all my chances. It was now or never. I had him like Kane and...
When I became Intercontinental Champion, I was honored to hold a title with such a vast legacy of greatness. I was excited to face new challengers as the landscape was evolving. A brash newcomer named Dolph Ziggler thought he had me figured out and brushed me to the side. My point of view of Dolph Ziggler coming in, I had the utmost respect for him. He was very exciting to watch. He had a style, but with a new spike to it, a new feel to it. I knew Dolph was hungry coming into this match, and he was one of the up-and-coming superstars. But there's a mistake that he made that you never make in this business. Dolph felt like he was already the Intercontinental Champion before our match had even started. So I made sure to teach him a very valuable lesson at the biggest party of the summer. At SummerSlam, Dolph's arrogance was going to be his downfall if I had my way. Championship, you know, that meant some more high-risk lucha libre too.
Three.
but he also showed his experience when he let me regroup right next to him while this was all going down and he was throwing his tantrum. Can't do that when you're against me.
Thank you.
bragging rights for the world heavyweight title. It was every man for himself. I would have thought that Batista would have known that walking into that match.
Right. I'm gonna rip your head off.
I'm no stranger to betrayal. Throughout my career, I had people that I thought were friends end up turning their backs on me. But this one, for some reason, it hit a very soft spot. I couldn't make sense of what had gone down.
You're supposed to be my friend!
If I would have known that this was gonna interfere in our friendship, I would have never have done what I did.
We had gone through so much together, and I just couldn't believe how quickly he could throw that all away.
I'm not thinking about what we've been through. I'm not thinking about you. I'm thinking about me.
After weeks of verbal and physical assaults, I knew that we could never go back to the way things were. I wanted to make him feel the same way I did, to return that feeling to him. And the best way I could think to do that was to beat him on SmackDown and get the number one contender spot that Batista felt belonged to him. Batista's game plan from the get-go was gonna be to manhandle me. It definitely did the trick. dropkick him back down to reality. He gave me a chance to reset the match, just a little, and I was happy to take it.
I was going out on my sword, you know?